Issues, the praise and the importance of the program in India. At the outset, let me compliment the organizers for being selected the topic. Even the Vice Chancellor is also expert in that area, the cancer area, and is very rightly taken up the area. And let me brief, even the maybe in the 2000 year, I was at Hassan as a HOD of the Panchikarma. That time, the Guruji has joined. The PG scholar as Panchakarma, that when he was my student, that time I was for a few months, I was the teacher and the guide for him. And later on, I moved to CCRS, and then he got his PG and he came. So he's a good practitioner and a good leader. So I see, I witness the institution, how it has grown, the chronology of the institution. And always I want to say, leading by a right, the person, leader, is very important. The institution to take a shape. And today I had again presentation and the briefing of the developments that shows again the growth of the institution that is going, the constant steady upgrowth is going on there. That indicates the very active role of the principal and his involvement. I must appreciate and compliment his dedication and the interest in shaping the institution. He was the previous from SCSM. We are conducting the principal's training. We make the principals to sit as a student for 5 days in the Delhi, and then we are training them on the educational administration. Anyway, our chairman will definitely brief all the capacity building programs. I will not touch that. But the involvement as a participant in the training program, that also shows his interest and energy to learn the things and implement the things there. That way, you are all very fortunate that to be led by an able principal who is also an academician and a practitioner. Most of the times, many of the principals are not practitioners. It is very important to know that the principal is a practitioner. This is the hard way. I must compliment the management also for selecting a principal and giving him a free hand to develop the institution. Because the few years back, when I was at principal KLE, I was in search of the stem cell research. I wanted to give one of my students the stem cells, especially which were Ayushkara, which can prolong the lifespan of the tissues of the individual. Those drugs are their Ayushkara. So those drugs I want to test on the stem cells, whether these Ayushkara drugs can expand the life of the stem cells or not. That way I was in search of the stem cell research. Then I came across, you know, I have that facility. And then I contacted Guruji, and also even my senior, Dr. Rajiv Subhadhyaya, who was the faculty member here also. And both of them I contacted. Then they coordinated my visit, and then I had the visit to the human research laboratory, and I had a meeting with the Vice Chancellor. Then we had entered the MOU, and that way then one of my students came here, and she did good work on the stem cell research. So that way I came across the institution. Then I had, we had collaborative study, and then it was very fruitful study was there. And they would have to prove that these drugs will enhance the replication capacity of the stem cells, how the residual drugs are there. A set of drugs were taken in that one. So that was a good study. It happened with the collaboration of the university. We were able to do that. So that and now that is expanded to further. And there is one more Ayush division has started. And that shows again the institution level importance and the how the institute is giving importance for the research. And now it is expanding it. Very, very appreciable. I have to appreciate the management also and Honorable Vice Chancellor for their insight into the research and providing facilities and expansions for that one. So then coming to the today's topic, cancer is again is going to be the big problem in India and a whole globe. And where we have a huge role to play in the coming days. Especially the department which is hosting the program, Russia's biological and Agatha. These two departments will going to play a major role, and Swasthavrutta. And the preventive aspects, Swasthavrutta will be having a much role. And the corona has taught us how the preventive aspects are most important. And the people are realizing that to adapt the preventive aspects are there. Now we need to develop the implementable protocols. The moment we say Swasthavrutta, the Swasthavrutta teachers, the students, everybody can recite Dinacharya slogans and say that this can be practicable. Even if themselves will not take to practice single school of that. So we need to customize those principles to the present. present days practicable things, and then give them, as we say, individualized approach. So we need to develop the protocols, how to implement individualized the daily protocols and just the dinacharya, etc., and then propagate them. Then definitely the public will be happy because they are eagerly waiting from us solutions. This is one point. Second one is Prasad by his Kalpana and Agatha. These two have very major role to play in the communities in terms of cancers. One is we are indulging all toxic materials by way of food adulteration, so many things, even air pollution, whatever things are there, any sort of things are going on. They are working as a dushi visha in our body, which is again, Agathas are required there to contract those visas which are we are daily indulging. That is one aspect. And again, the Rasa Shastra, the drugs are having very potential role in the playing the management of the cancer. So there are practices going on, even Ravi also mentioned that Satyananda Bhatt's they practice also. Like where there are people who are practicing very well in the cancer management side there. And we also ALU started that time the higher oncology program. We have established the cancer unit there, integrated cancer unit, and then we started the higher oncology fellowship program. Maybe 3-4 batches people have completed, and everyone is doing a very good practice, a marriage practice. They are not talking about local practice, but only everything practice with the scientific way is being done there. That way, I also recommended to the Vice Chancellor, being Indian University, they can start the fellowship programs also, where we are going to start only DM programs. So they have scope to start the fellowship programs, they can do it that also. That way, the cancer have very potential role tomorrow to play, and where we need to gear up ourselves and develop proper protocols and then proper methodology to preventive and curative, and even rehabilitative part also. So this conference definitely will be sharing a lot of information, a lot of protocols, for treatment points, but this all the delegates will be very, very fruitful also. And coming to my LCSM activities, which we have done for the educational reforms, and everyone is some of experiencing, some are eagerly waiting for next step, what we have done them. That, as Guruji also mentioned, so we have brought competency-based liberal education, or it's called as outcome-based liberal education. This is the first time in the history of our Ayush systems we brought this type of the reforms, total reformation in the syllabus. The syllabus, when we say it was, even Chairman was mentioning sometimes when he went to a WHO meeting somewhere, then somebody introduced him as the CCM president at that time. And then somebody, the WHO people told, yes, we know CCIU. Then he was surprised, how we know the CCIU? Then they told, the smallest syllabus prepared by CCM in the world, in the world, smallest syllabus. So then when we look back, there is a Charaka Purvartha, Charaka Uttaratha. There is only one line syllabus is there. So that way it was the comment by somebody else. Now we have taken all the feedback. We have taken very methodical, there is a long process is there. So we have done a survey by the students, more than 1,500 students have participated in the survey. They have given inputs there. Then we have taken the requirements for 2030. 2030, what are the challenges by our students, what they are going to face it, what qualities they require to face by 2030 as a practitioners and even at the global level. So that was the taken as inputs, and then we shaped the syllabus into the and the curriculum into the 2030 requirements. So that was the our process which we have taken. And so then we brought out a competency-based education. It is objective oriented, exactly what is required to be learned, what is required to be taught, and how to be they taught, how to be teaching, and then how to train them, how to assist them well. Many times they may teach well, they may train well, but in examinations they may fail to examine what is to be learned by students. It is not objective oriented. Why the question is, what for the question is, what someone to learn, what the question is there, what the why is there, there is no link between those two ones. It is all fragmented. So we want to bring up all those ones and give it a link of everything. We made a blueprint of question paper, objective methodology and we gave that one. So that we defined very clearly what is the method of teaching, what is the method of training, what is the method of assessment task. So it became an objective oriented completely. This is one thing. Second one is, if students want at a time more practical. The every feedback gives, we want more practical knowledge. So that way, our chairperson will give an idea, we will go for the non-lecturers. So even my as a principal, so I also observed it. Whenever the students are involved in activity, they never find the time. We have to tell them, time is over, you have to leave to the next class. Otherwise, in a regular class, what happens? The students will be always missing out, going away, and we need to control them. So here, when you make didn't control them. So they themselves are involved in that work. So that was the learning lessons for me also. So when even our chairman told one is to two ratio, this was 1 hour you teach and 2 hours you go for activity-based learning. So that was a very rapid change or the total change, transformation which we can bring it down. That has given very good result also. Even all of you as first year students and second year students have experienced it. And the feedback what we got is throughout country, we got 20% of result high because of this system of the implementation of the curriculum syllabus throughout country. And we brought out the academic calendar. Earlier what happens, whenever we announce the PG examination, then there is a flooding of mail stamps. Our internship not completed, exam delayed, this problem is there, this postponed examination. When we began postponing, the students who completed the exam, they have to have wait nearly 8 months to 12 months, they have to wait for the PG entrance. To minimize the wastage of time, so we brought academic calendar. Now this is first time throughout India, and one time exam was there, result was announced in second year started. So we are able to streamline the courses. So these are the principal reforms there. Even activity-based learning, when we involve activity, so we want to have edutainment, that means you entertainment and education. You enact or you play and learn. So that was another new introduction which we brought into that one, so that we have a stressless free environment for the education. Otherwise, the teacher is very strict and you are sitting with a very controlled environment and under tension or the controlled environment. We don't want to be the controlled environment for learning. We want the free environment for learning. So we made an activity-based learning and involvement, entertainment, likewise. And also we want, maybe the middle education, we may not give participants sports. But all of you know it, GAM is very important. So we kept a period for sports and even library period. Then cultural activities also, talent exhibition. You may have some talent. You don't have a platform to get to show your talents. But anyway, overcome the stress and execute talents. We created monthly 1 period recreational activity. So we have taken care of 360 degree approach. So that we want every individual to grow as a complete man, complete human being. So not only one education, a bookworm, we say bookworm. We don't want bookworms. We want a complete human being. So that way we have taken care of the curriculum to give a shape to all aspects there. That is the one part of education. Second one is when you see any other science, they have some of the allied sciences. You will see a medical science, you see X-ray, maybe ECG, the MRI or CT, whatever things are there. Different sciences joined together, innovation will not happen. So then we want to have our own system also to have allied sciences, knowledge, information, and to do research, integrative research, and to move on innovations. So we want to sensitize our people for all allied branches. So we brought out online elective courses on different subjects. All elective courses. The students can learn through online only, and there is a limitation for these ones. We made mandatory 9, but they can have unlimited number of electives, they can enroll and they can learn it. This is another new revolution which we brought up to the education system. This is, there is also a very good idea, which our chairman's idea is there, that we brought up this one. That has been brought up. Likewise, it's all the education reforms which we brought up, and unless until you people involve it and implement it and then give a right for positive feedback, or you can say the structured feedback or the constructive feedback, is that not more simply criticizing, simply old is very good, is of that one. We involve it, implement it, and then they take the feedback, observe it, and what is the problem, then give a constructive feedback, then we can modify and minimize it. Because the globe is open already, because our government has already brought out Heal by India, Heal India program. Heal by India, where your people can be trained to the global standards and you go to the foreign countries and you can practice there. Heal India is our hospitals are upgraded to the international standards where foreign patients come here and take the treatment here. So these two programs are being promoted well by government of India. So to encash all those ones, you people have to have global competence. We are trying to implement that. Unless until teachers understand that the process what we are having, the thinking process behind the reforms what we are making now, and implement the same the tempo what we are thinking of and what we are giving them, and you people learn those ones, then only the system develops to grow it and become a globalization. That is all your roles is there. If for example a Shastra is there, but we want to bring your UG level as a clinicians, so what we did is we made the manufacturing of the drug development into one paper, one paper given yogas. So what yogas also, we want to know what is being practiced in the society. That only yogas to be given in the syllabus. Otherwise, feedback is the students. What you teach is not available in the market, but is available you don't teach in the class. That was the feedback to the students. So this we got to understand. Then we go to the company, they give the name of the medicines which are being sold out maximum in the society, in the market, and those drugs which are being practiced by the practitioners was included in the syllabus. So that we bridge up the gap. So what is being sold in the market, the same will be taught in the classrooms. So this way we are bringing out the objectivity to the public education. We want to have 360 degree approach into the public curriculum. I request everyone to raise the occasion and also join with the hands of the NCSM efforts and implement it, and then they will put the global standards, and then take Ayurveda to the global levels, and we are going to flourish and we will develop them. Once again, I compliment the whole management and the principal and all the amazing team for taking a very big event and is making it successful of this one, and has invited me to share some of my ideas there. Thank you very much to all of you.